morning, my dear students. So once again, in English, we started our first chapter related to a God. So in our last video, we showed that what lecture written in the letter and what is the reaction of the postman in the letter while he showed that this letter to a God. And postmaster also laughed in the letter, but then postmaster was serious and he did what? He don't want to let the lecturer's faith from the God. So that is why he decided to give a reply of the letter. But when he actually opened the letter, he came to know that what that he did not need only a goodwill and pen and paper, ink and paper, but he needed something more from the God. So at that time, we all know that Lancho needs 100 peso from the God. But now postmaster did not have that much money. So what he did, he started collecting from his colleagues, from his friends who wanted to do charity. Okay, and he also gave some part of his own salary. But he is failed to collect 100 peso. He can collect half, more than the half of the amount, means around 70-80 pesos. Okay. So he brought a ledger, means he signed behalf of the God, and he made a cover and he put all the pesos in the cover, and then he address of the Lancho. Okay, so now what happened when Lancho came at the post office? Okay, let's see. Okay, now let's read and understand. The following Sunday, Lancho came a little earlier than usually to ask if there was a letter for him. Okay, now what happened? That Lancho came again at the post office to ask that if there is a letter for him. Okay, but on that Sunday he did what? He come bit earlier than usually to ask, means when he regularly came to the post office, but on that Sunday he comes some earlier. Okay, as example, if every day he came at 10 o'clock, at that day he came on 9 o'clock. It was the postman himself who handed a letter to him while the postmaster. So it was the postman himself who handed the letter to him while the postmaster, experiencing the contentment, satisfaction of a man who has performed a good deed, looked on from his office. So a postman who is giving, we already know that who prepared that letter and who prepared that envelope for the lecture. So when the postman himself is giving handed over a letter to the lecture, at that time postmaster was watching all these things from his office, and he is feeling very much good. He is feeling a contentment means a satisfaction. Whenever if we do any kind of charity work, whenever if we help someone, whenever we can, means we do any kind of good thing, at that time there is a different kind of happiness in our mind and in our heart, and there is a different kind of satisfaction that yes, I did this. Okay, so what happened that year, the postmaster have a satisfaction. He all together make money. Okay, not make money, but to collect money from everyone who got into the charity. Okay, and that is why he has a one kind of satisfaction. Okay, when he watching all these things from his office. Let's have a look next paragraph. Lancho showed not the slightest surprise on seeing the money. Lancho has not any kind of surprise when he showed the money. Why? He had not at that time when if this kind of situation is happen, so we should surprise, we should shock. But here Lancho did not do that. Why? Because he has a confidence, that much confidence that God will send me, God is there and he will help. So he has not any kind of surprise. But when he actually opened the envelope, at that time he is little bit angry. Now we all know why he is angry. God could not have made a mistake, nor could he have denied Lancho what he had requested. So what he did, that help means God never made a mistake. What is the mistake? Now Lancho need how much money? He need 100 pesos, right? But here what happened, that the postmaster is failed to collect the 100 pesos, and whatever the amount the postmaster have, he put in the envelope and then he gave to the Lancho. So here Lancho told what, that the God never made a mistake or never denied what Lancho requested. Means Lancho requested for the 100 pesos, so God will never deny whatever my request. Here, so let's have a look in the next one. So there is one picture of the office, okay? Means post office. Immediately Lancho went up to the window to ask for a paper and ink. So immediately he went to the window and asked for the paper and ink. On the public writing table he started to write with much wrinkling on his brow. Much wrinkling on his brow means he is in a tension. Okay, he has been some, was tension also, angry also. He need what, paper and ink, and he started, see there is a public table, okay, usually on the means at the post office this kind of table is available, okay, for writing. So he go on the public table and he started writing with the means in some tension, in some angriness, okay. Why, what is the reason? Caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. Now he wanted to express his ideas, okay. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stand which should be lit and then affixed to the envelope with the blow of his fist, okay. So he wrote something on the letter, whatever his ideas, whatever he wanted to write, he wrote this in the angriness. He didn't feel satisfaction that it's okay, I got this much money, but he has an angriness, okay. And for that angriness, he wanted to write something to the board, and this one he took a paper and ink from the window, and he started writing, and then he buy a what stand, as I already told you in the last video, that stand is very much necessary whenever you wanted to post a letter. So he buy a stand and he fix the stand, and then he once again post a letter. So let's look at in the next paragraph what he got once again to the board. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster went to open it. Now we all know that there is no any kind of God who giving the answer to the Lancho. The postmaster himself, God for the Lancho, is giving the reply. Okay, so whenever the Lancho mail the letter to the box, and when he went, postmaster immediately go and check the letter of Lancho and he open for the reading. Okay, for reading. It said, what Lancho written in the letter, let's have a look. God, of the money that I asked for, only 70 peso reached me. So we all know that how much money Lancho need? Lancho need 100 pesos. And we show that postmaster is failed to collect the 100 peso. He can collect half then more. So it is a 17 pesos. Send me the rest since I need it very much. So now we need very much. We need 100 pesos and the postmaster sent the only 70 pesos. So the other 30 pesos is remaining. So what Lenzo said that I need it very in means badly. So please send me, but don't send into me through the mail because the post office employees are a bunch of props, means dishonest, Lenzo. So now here, see, Lenzo did not know that post of the employees of the post office themselves given the money to the Lenzo. And what he wrote in the letter that the employees of the post office, they are crooks. Crooks means dishonest. So please don't send me money from the mailbox. Please send me money directly because the crooks, they are dishonest. Means he feels that God sent him 100 pesos, but the employees of the post office, they took 30 pesos. Okay? So here we come to know about, see, this is the end of the chapter number 1, a letter to a God. So about means, see, what is the message of the, or what is the moral of the chapter? When, if we are not able to know that who is going to or who will help you or who help us in any kind of matter, so without knowing anything, we should not blame the people. Sometimes this is happened with you also, that someone who is actually helping you, you are blaming them. Okay? But that those people are already helping you. So you should come to know that who is your well-wisher and who is helping to you. So you have to understand about this and you have to reward, you have to faith in all the people, not only in the God. Okay? So here we have end of the chapter number 1, a letter to a God. Okay? So let's have a look, a quick look in the exercise. Answer the following questions. The first one is, why did Lenzo say the raindrops were like the new coins? Now why the Lenzo is comparing raindrops with the new coins? We already seen in the chapter that Lenzo hoped that these drops of rain would give a good crop and then he would have a rich store of the corn for his family. That's why he called a raindrops a new coins. Clear? So we all know that because if the raindrop is there, if the downpour is there, then the crop is good, and if the crop is good, he have a good money. And so there is a comparison of the raindrop with the new coins. Second one, what were the Lenzo's feeling when the hail stopped? So the feeling of Lenzo when the hail stopped. So Lenzo was filled with the sadness. We all know that because of the hailstorms, because of that rain of ice cubes, all the cornfield of the Lenzo is totally destroyed. So of course he feels sadness. His corn was totally destroyed. He had to his sons that they wouldn't have no corn that year, but he was hopeful of getting help from the God. But still he has a faith in a God. Okay. Next one, third one is, who does Lenzo have complete faith in? See, there are two different kind of question and answer in one. Answer is only one. Describe Lenzo's quality in light of his faith in God. Okay, so there are two questions. See the answer. Who does Lenzo have a complete faith? So Lenzo has a complete faith in a God. Okay, or describes quality in light of basic farmer and who will fulfill the family needs by the farming. Once his crops were destroyed due to the heavy rainfall and hailstones, and he was afraid to think how his family would survive. Okay, so because of the hailstorm, his crop field is totally destroyed. So it is now problematic for the lancho. Okay, how his family's needs to be fulfilled. See here. Here the need is what the need is used, not the wishes. Need means the our basic needs to eat, to means to have clothes somehow. Okay, and wishes means I need this kind of clothes, I need this kind of food. Okay, so here they don't use the word wish, they use the word need. He knew that God would help him in this life. He had firm faith in God. He believed that God would not let him be hungry. God उसको भूखा नहीं मारेंगे, ऐसे उसको क्या थी, एक उम्मीद थी, एक विश्वास था. Okay? Nowadays faith in a God like a lancho is almost impossible and unseen. Nowadays we should means there is no any kind of faith in a God. Okay? People are very much aware that nobody is willingly to help others without any self-interest. Means we all know that if nowadays there are very less people who are helping without any kind of self-interest. उनके मतलब के बिना आजकल कोई हेल्प करता नहीं है. ऐसे लोग अगर बिना मतलब के कोई हेल्प करने वाला हो, ऐसे लोग दुनिया में बहुत कम है. Lancho's reaction towards post office was not right or justified, but it was just because of his emotions, as he could not believe that God had done such a mistake. If it were only the post office employees who had stolen money according to him. Okay, actually the postmaster and the employees of the post office, they helped to the lancho, but he thought that the employees of the post office, he himself, what he did, he stolen his money, because he told the money to send 100 pesos and there is 70 pesos in the envelope. Next question, why does the postmaster send money to the lancho? Why does he sign the letter to God? Okay, so the postmaster sent money to lancho. So lancho, in order to keep lancho's faith. Now why postmaster is ready to give reply? Because he don't want to lose the faith of lancho in a God. So that is why he himself ready to give the answer. In God alive and firm, as he was completely moved by age, when postmaster reads the letter of lancho to God, he became serious and does not want to shake his faith and decides to answer the letter. He gathered money with the help of his post office employees and friends on behalf of God and signed a letter God so that lancho's faith does not get shaken. Okay, we all know this. I explained this very explained this properly in the chapter. A letter to God is a story that shows how deeply people believe in God. The simple minded people believe that they can write to God. Lancho, a poor hard working farmer, is grief stricken when his fields are destroyed by the hailstones. He is worried about the survival of his family. The postmaster and other later as a god. Okay. See. Next one. Did Lancho try to find out who had sent the money? Why not? So Lancho never tried to find out that who sent him the money and why not. So the explanation is there in the answer. Okay. And the last question is, who was Lancho and what circumstances forced him to write a letter to God? This is in our first paragraph, that Lancho is a farmer, a hardworking farmer, and why he forced to write a letter to a God, because of the hailstorm, his total corn field got destroyed, and that is why he has a holy hope in a God, and that is why he had to. Which circumstances? The conflicts got totally destroyed. These circumstances forced him to write a letter to a God. Okay. So here is all the questions. I will send you this presentation in your group. So what you have to do? You have to write all the word means and also the phrases and idioms and all the question answers in your notebook. Okay, you have to, means whenever you have a time, send your parents to the school for checking of the notebook.